First of all, our security, Ghana's security, is intimately bound and wound up with the security of the ECOWAS community. We're not an island to ourselves. If the part of the community is burning in one part, at some stage or another, it'll affect us. The issues in Mali are issues that are duplicated in virtually every single one of the 15 member states of ECOWAS. The religious differences between North and South, in some places, internal differences within Muslim state. Mali is essentially Muslim, but there's still important differences. The fact that, for instance, the involvement of Kenya in trying to resolve the problems of Somalia has then imported some of these problems into Kenya. It's not something that therefore justifies Kenya not doing anything about it.
But that's also a reality that you'd have to contend with.
We will contend with it.
Taking a decision.
We are going to have to contend with that reality. We will contend with it. But it always, like in all transactions involving states, at the end of the day, you weigh it up and you decide on balance, which is the one that most promotes your national security, your national interest, the collective interest of the community to which you are born.
So you're saying Nana Akuffo-Addo, as president, will adopt the more interventionist approach in dealing with
adopting a more interventionist approach. If ECOWAS has taken a decision that it is going to enter militarily, it is for Ghana to support ECOWAS. And the Akufo-Addo government is not going to come up to say Ghana's turning its back on that consensus.
The Ivorian situation. You, correct me if I'm wrong, sir, you accuse the current government of harboring or providing asylum for pro-Gbagbo loyalists in Ghana.
I didn't accuse the government. I brought to the attention of the Ghanaian people a report conducted under the auspices of the United Nations Security Council.
This is an interim report.
The report, interim, final, a report of the United Nations Security Council.
Interim only because it's being disputed by the Ghanaian government. Ghanaian authorities say they are part of the story, have not been factored into the complete report.
But it is a report of the United Nations Security Council, the agency charged with the maintenance of international peace and security. They came to Ghana, they found certain facts, and they made the report of them. Those facts do not tell a good story. They speak of meetings being held here by former members of the Laurent Gbagbo regime who are resident in our country, the purpose of which was to plan the destabilization of the Ouattara.
These have been rebutted by the Ghanaian government.
What, that the meetings took place?
That there's no evidence of these suggestions by the interim UN report.
You mean that the meetings did not take place?
That there's no evidence that any of these
meetings. They gave you the names, the venue. That's a very dangerous matter for our country. If meetings like that can take place in Ghana and our own national security...
What will you do about that?
You wouldn't make it happen. Our country has been a country which has a very proud reputation for taking in refugees.
Would you have them arrested and deported?
The Akufo-Addo's government is not going to tolerate any refugees in Ghana using Ghanaian soil to attack a neighboring country.